Hello everyone, welcome to Code and Learn. So in this video, we are going to set up our DevTools for our project. If you come from a different language background, maybe like npm for JavaScript, you are probably aware that we install DevTools using dev dependencies and then run them using scripts in our package.json file. For Go, things are a bit different. Starting version 1.24, you can actually define those tools in Go mod. For now, we will use what the Go community has been using for a while now, which is tools.go. First thing I'm going to do is, in our makefile, I'm going to define a Go bin. This is where all the binaries for our Go tool will be kept. So that's our Go bin. We are defining it in the root of the project in the .bin directory. Now, the first tool that I'm going to install is Golang CLI lint. A linting tool is used to catch errors earlier and keep your code idiomatic. There are a bunch of rules for Golang CLI lint that you can configure. This is done using creating a file called golangci.yaml. So I will create one in the root of the project, golangci.yaml. It also accepts other file types. You can read that in the documentation. I will provide a link to which in the video description. So let me copy the basic configuration that I use for most of my projects. So as you can see, we are configuring the run to concurrently run up to 4 threads. If an issue is found, we want to exit with code 1. We also want to lint test file and the timeout is 5 minutes. Now there are different options that you can configure, but I will leave it up to you so that you can check whichever one is valid for your project. Now there are different linter rules that can be configured with linter settings. Like here we have one for error check, go critic, go cyclo, and so on. So these are all the different rules that I am going to use. You can copy paste this file from the GitHub repo for this project. Now we need to install the Golang CI binary. For that, I'm going to use the makefile. Now we created the go bin directory. Now let's initialize a shell so that that go bin is set in the path for the makefile. For that, I will define shell and set the path variable to include what we have in go binary. So we will prepend go underscore bin to what we already have in the path variable. If this is not set, just use the shell we already have. So that's defining the shell here. Now I will update the FMD to use Golang CLI lint instead. Here is the command that I will use, which is Golang CLI -lint run --fix. That is, fix our issues and error out if issue is not fixable by running the command. Now to install tools, I will create a new phony target, which I will call tools. First thing I will do is create the go bin directory if it doesn't exist already. For that, I will use mkdir -parent and go bin. Usually you would install the go binary for a dev tool using tools.go file, but Golang CI docs recommend it to be installed from the source directly. For that, I will use curl. So curl get the install.script, run with shell and download into our go binary. Now let's try this. Make tools. We got an error because mkdir command was not found. That is because we need to also enclose this, that is the path or the existing path, so that existing tools can be used. Let's try it again. And as you can see, we are downloading Golang CLI lint. And if I open the .bin directory, you can see that we have the binary downloaded. Let me clear the console. Now let's move on to installing tools using tools.go file. For that, we need to create a tools.go file in the root of the project. So we will say package main. I will add a build tag so that this is not included in our build binary. I will just say tools. Inside it, by usual convention, you would have underscore imports. Something like this. We are going to use mockgen in our next lesson. So I will use mockgen as an example. By adding an import or underscore import, what we will be able to do is we can manage this dependency using go mod. So if I run go mod tidy or make tidy, you will see it's installing mockgen. If you don't do this, we won't be able to track the dependency using go mod. And whenever you run go mod tidy, it will be removed because we are not using it in our code. So let's try that. So I will comment this out. Let me do go get minus u mockgen. So now as you can see, the mockgen is being downloaded. But if I run go mod tidy, you will see it has been removed because we are not using it in our project. But if I do this or uncomment this and then do tidy, you will see imports are added back. So that is basically the idea of tools.go. It allows us to track the dependencies using GoMod. Now, in our makefile, we need to add a grep so that the tools can be picked up from our tools.go file and installed into the go bin that we created. For that, I'm just going to copy paste the script. So what the script is basically doing is, it is reading the content of tools.go, grepping everything that has an underscore, fetching the package name, and then using go install to install into our go binary. Since we are providing an environment variable go bin that is set to our go underscore bin, so the tool should be installed here. Now let's try this out. Clear it, make tools, and as you can see, mockgen was also installed in our .bin directory. Let's create a gitignore because we don't want bin to be included in our repo. Now that our golang CLI lint is installed, let us run fmt. As you can see, it's picking up multiple errors. Let's fix some of them and I will let you fix the rest of them. So here, the linter is complaining because we are not wrapping the error that we are returning. For that, there's a simple fix. What we can do is just say fmt errorf parse config and then wrap the error, which is the error we get. So that should fix it. Let's try again. As you can see, that has been removed from the linter listing the errors. So I will let you fix the rest of them. If you encounter any issues, please post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. So that's it for this lesson. To recap, we installed golang clint, fetching it from its source, and then using tools.go to install mockgen, which is the conventional way of downloading and using DevTools. That's it for this lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please post a comment under the video or reach out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding!